1970, these four young New Yorkers decided that just playing music wouldn't make them millionaires, but that maybe adding white makeup, black tight-fitting costumes, some sequins and 7-inch heels, some subtle touches like spitting blood and burning guitars, would. 3 gold and 5 platinum albums later, it looks like they've hit on something.
It really goes back to the old, you know, basis that we started the group, and that's that we care. We go out. You won't find me in Tahiti getting a suntan. You know, I owe my fans. They make me what I am. So to be able to go into a store and sign autographs or go to a radio station and shake hands with a disc jockey is important. I should never think that I'm above that. You know, too many people believe all their own hype.
KX Suitcase with Paula Stanley.
Hey, you gonna do any more solo albums?
I don't know. First, we gotta do a KISS album because everybody keeps wondering if we're breaking up, so we're gonna show everybody and we're gonna do a new album.
All right.
All right?
See you later.
Bye-bye, Robert. I know too much about Gene. I know things that I can't even tell you.
You know how he spits fire?
Yeah.
Well, how did I do that?
I can't tell you, but I gotta tell you, don't ever try that. That's not for anybody to try. That's for you to enjoy when you do it.
Does it ever scare you that people will claw their way through their friends to get to you?
It can be pretty frightening. In Japan, once or twice, I really thought I'd had it. I thought this was it. You know, what a way to die on top.
Hard life. It's not always this glamorous, but I enjoy it.
But can you honestly say you enjoy meeting disc jockey after disc jockey, screaming teenager after screaming teenager?
Every screaming teenager is different. I enjoy it a lot, sure. I mean, to that particular teenager, if she's female, she's the only one that really matters.
Show up as much to see the costume and makeup as to meet Paul Stanley himself, which is why the members of KISS are never seen in public without costumes and makeup. Well, almost never. People magazine got this shot of Paul and actually got the camera and film away from Paul's bodyguard intact.
I've heard that you and the other members of the group have this obsession about not wanting your pictures taken when you're not wearing makeup.
We own a very large collection of cameras and film.
Really? What, if somebody gets a picture, you take the camera away?
Well, we'll take the film and we'll pay them for it. Yeah. I mean, we're not in the camera business, so we... Yeah.
But it's really that important?
Yeah, I think so. I think we care that much. It's not an obsession as much as we care.
So what is it like for you walking down the street with no makeup?
Well, I really don't look that different. You know, I'm not quite this pale.
I love you.
Why is it that you are very determined not to be photographed without the makeup? Is that part of the mystique?
Yeah, mystique. Mystique played a big part in Hollywood during the 40s and 30s. Stars were bigger than life. I think we lost a lot of that in rock music around 1969, 1970. In the early 60s, mid-60s, you had all the English bands. And when you looked at them, nobody in the Stones looked like they belonged in the Beatles. You always knew by looking at the band that they were part of a unit. So we just decided to go back to that. During the late 60s, you had everybody taking a lot of drugs and going to see groups, and you had light shows. And basically, the reason for the light show was because the band was so boring. So what we figured is, as long as you're paying, you might as well see something.
Give
Yeah.
Yeah. And he takes his guitar and he makes all this fire and smoke and sparks come out of his guitar. He plays really great.
Paul Stanley. It's what a young New Yorker named Stanley Eisen started out to become 9 years ago. And now that he's made it, he says he couldn't be happier.
If you wanted to be president all your life and you became president, you wouldn't have much to complain about. I don't think you'd have much right to complain, and I always wanted to be what I am.